Hey guys, welcome back. Today on The Untidy Artist, I'll be showing you how I make bath bomb embeds. A bath bomb embed is a small concentrated bath bomb that's placed inside a normal bath bomb. And what you get in your bathtub is this fun pop of color all of a sudden from the center of the bath bomb. There are three different ways that you can color a bath bomb embed, and I will be showing you three different techniques today. These are easy to make and a fun addition to any bath bomb once you've mastered a basic bath bomb. So let's grab some supplies and get started. The basic ingredients that you'll need for all embeds is citric acid and baking soda. That's what creates our fizziness. We'll be using some melted coconut oil. I have some 91% rubbing alcohol in a bottle and in spray form. And then I also have some polysorbate 80, and I will go into more detail about why I use this in my embeds. The first way that we'll be coloring our embeds is with mica, and I will be using Pink Vibrance from Nurture Soap. Next, we have a liquid water-based colorant from Celestial Colors. This is FD&C and D&C cosmetic grade colors that are skin safe. We will also be using this bath bomb powder from Wholesale Supplies Plus. This is a lake and it's in powder form. I have a spatula, a whisk, some measuring spoons, and a half cup measuring cup. For the different types of molds, I'll actually be using the teaspoon from my measuring spoons. And then I also found these on Amazon, and I tried out a lot of different molds before I found some I really loved. I like these because they're really sturdy and solid, and on the bottom you can flip them over and the rubber allows you to push the embeds out of the mold, and these come in a 4-pack and they are my favorite. I also have these smaller silicone molds that I found. These are fun if you want to put a lot of different colors of embeds or use smaller embeds in your bath bombs. And these make these little tiny embeds, and this mold works really well for that. What you do want to watch for when picking out a mold is that it's not super pliable. This is a silicone mold and it's so soft that if you try and press the embeds into it, they won't hold their shape. I have some little cups we'll be measuring our colorants in. The first technique I'll be showing you is how to make embeds with mica. So the first step is to grab your coconut oil. I take a big scoop of it, and you can melt it down in your microwave or over your stovetop, whichever you prefer. And then you're going to measure out 1/2 teaspoon of the melted coconut oil into one of your little cups. Then you're going to measure in 1/2 teaspoon of your rubbing alcohol. And this is the 91% rubbing alcohol. And then for your polysorbate 80. So you'll be using 1/4 teaspoon of the polysorbate 80. This helps mix everything together. It helps to not stain your bathtub. It makes sure that all the mica mixes into the water instead of just floating on the top, and I highly recommend it. Then you're gonna grab a little whisk, give it a little stir, and then you're going to grab a bowl, measure out 1/2 cup of your baking soda, and I'm putting in 2 teaspoons of my mica. Now you can use 1 to 2 teaspoons of the mica, depending on how colored you want them to be. I like using 2 teaspoons because it gives me really pretty embeds. Then I'm going to grab my whisk and my spatula, and I'm going to go back and forth and make sure that my mica is mixed really well into my baking soda. Then I'm going to take my liquids that I already have mixed together and pour them into the baking soda. One tip is to grab a little scoop of the dry ingredients, put it into the cup to get all of the liquid out of the cup, because we don't want to leave any of that behind. And then I'm going to grab my whisk and once again go back and forth from my whisk to my spatula to really make sure that all of the liquid ingredients are mixed in to my baking soda. So you can see I'm using the side of the spatula to really press that liquid in. We want it all mixed evenly, and this does take a while. But once that is all evenly mixed together, I'm going to add my citric acid. And you'll notice that I waited to add that until the end. It gives us a much more fizzy and awesome embed. And I'm going to use my whisk and my spatula to make sure that that's mixed together. And then using gloves, you have to use gloves with all of these unless you like colored hands. Squeeze it together and see if it holds together when you drop it back down into the bowl. If it doesn't, grab your spray alcohol and give it a couple sprays and then mix it together again and then test it. Once it holds together in your hand, when you drop it back into the bowl, it should hold its shape. You'll know that it has enough of the liquid in it. You don't want to add too much of the liquid. So you can see as I drop that back down in the bowl, it holds its shape. Then I'm going to grab my mold. I put down a piece of parchment paper and I'm going to put all of my mixture into one of the molds, and this fits perfectly. So you'll remember we used a half cup of baking soda and a half cup of citric acid with our colorant ingredients. And then I'm just going to evenly press that into the mold. And I use my fingers and the palm of my hand and really make sure that all of that mixture is pressed down into the mold. And this is why it's important to use a mold that's sturdy, because as you're pressing that down, you don't want the mold to lose its shape. So I make sure that's all pressed down. And then I use the parchment paper to get any of the parts that have fallen out. And I put that into the mold also. So you're using all of your bath bomb or your embed mixture. And then you set that aside and let it dry. Okay, so that was our mica that we use to make embeds. Now we're going to use our liquid colorant from Celestial Colors. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab my teaspoon and I'm going to measure in anywhere from about 20 to 35 drops of my colorant. And I'm using two different colors from Celestial Colors. And then we're going to finish filling up the half teaspoon with our rubbing alcohol. So this is taking the place of the half teaspoon of just rubbing alcohol that we added to the mica embeds. Then I'm going to put in my half teaspoon of melted coconut oil, my 1/4 teaspoon of polysorbate 80, and give it a good stir. Then I'm going to take my half cup of baking soda that's already in my bowl, and I'm going to pour in my liquid colorant. Once again, taking some of the dry ingredients, mixing it into the little cup, and I actually use my fingers on this part to get every little last bit of the colorant out of the cup. And this is why it's important to wear gloves. These colors are very concentrated and they will dye your hands, I know from experience. And then I'm actually going to use my hands with this part at the beginning to really mix the colorant into the baking soda. Then I'm gonna grab my whisk, make sure it's completely combined together, and once it is, we're gonna add our citric acid. Give that a good stir. And then, so this is how you would use the teaspoon to shape your embeds. You just get a scoop of it, press it on the side of the bowl, and tap it onto the counter. So you can see I'm just scooping some up, really pressing it into the side of the bowl and tapping it onto the counter. Now, this works really well. It takes a long time, and I feel like I'm standing there forever making embeds, so that's why I like using a mold, but this definitely is an option if you don't want to purchase a mold. And this gives you perfectly sized little embeds to go in your bath bombs. So I actually just took the rest of that mixture and pressed it into one of my other molds using the same technique I did with the mica, and I set that aside. The final technique we'll be doing is with our lakes. Now, lakes normally require you to mix them with water. For whatever reason, Wholesale Supplies Plus, their bath bomb colorants are fine mixed with rubbing alcohol, but you will want to make sure that you're using the correct liquid with the lakes that you're using. So I measured in a half teaspoon of rubbing alcohol, or you'd use water, and a half teaspoon of my powdered blue lakes. Lakes come in a lot of gorgeous colors. I will list below some of my favorite brands. So you're gonna whisk that together really well until all of the powder is absorbed into the liquid. And then you're going to add in your 1/4 teaspoon of polysorbate 80 and your 1/2 teaspoon of coconut oil, and you're going to mix that together really well. Then you're going to pour that into your baking soda just like you did with the Celestial colorants. Mix that together really well, add your citric acid, give it a few sprays of your rubbing alcohol if it needs some more liquid, and press it into your mold. So the technique of pressing it into your mold is exactly the same on each of the different types of colorants that you use. Go ahead and set that aside. These dry pretty quickly. Sometimes it takes a couple hours, and normally I like to leave them overnight so they're nice and dry, and then you're going to flip them out of the mold, and you'll notice that this mold works really well because you can press them out of the mold and it makes them pop right out. And we have our bath bomb embeds. All of the recipes for each type of embed I've made in this video will be listed below, as well as links of where to purchase everything. And these are our awesome embeds. Now, to store these, you'll want to put them in an airtight container, and then they're ready to use whenever you're making bath bombs. So I just store these in a nice little flip top jar. Now to use them, I'll show you how I put them in my bath bombs. So I have my bath bomb mixture here. And if you are new to making bath bombs, you'll wanna check out a basic bath bomb tutorial, but I just fill the first half of the bath bomb, press in my embed, put a little bit more of my mixture on top of that, fill my second half of my bath bomb and press them together. I will put links for all of my other bath bomb videos below in the description as well. Press that together really well. I tap on both sides and I make sure both sides release. And then I actually let mine dry in the bath bomb mold. So this is what the embeds look like if you were to just drop one in some water, and you can see how fast they fizz and how intensely colored they are. I love the mica because it gives a shimmery kind of look to your water. The lakes and the FDNC colorants and DNC colorants are going to color your water more. So if you're looking for a more colored water in the bathtub, you'd want to consider using lakes or the liquid colorants from Celestial Colors. It really just depends on what you already have in stock and what technique works best for you. And here you can see one of the embeds. This bath bomb has already been fizzing in the water for a minute. And you can see as it fizzes that all of a sudden, the color in the middle starts to come out and color the water. And it's just a really fun thing to add to your bath bombs. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope this was helpful. This was a video that I had a lot of requests for. It was a lot of fun to put together, kind of tricky to put together, but I wanted to give you guys as many different techniques in making these as I could. Please remember that all of this information is below in the description of the video. If you have any comments or questions, please post those below. Please check out some of my other tutorials on my YouTube channel and subscribe if you like what you see. Be sure to click on that like button if you enjoyed this video, and click on the bell icon to be alerted of any new tutorials that I come out with. You can also follow me on Instagram if you're feeling social and see what new projects I'm working on and a little peek into my daily crazy life. You guys are awesome. Thanks so much for all of your support, and we'll see you next time.